So first of all, a big thank you to all of you for having spent one full week of your activities here. I think I had already shared with you the thought processes which led to these and the subsequent workshops. I did not emphasize one thing then, which I would like to do now. You people represent institutions which are several shades above a large number of engineering colleges in the country. Just as you regard IITs and some of the NITs to have a stronger ethos, similarly, 4,000 colleges in the country regard all of you as having an equivalently stronger ethos. Now, one of the arguments that has always been made again and again in spite of our efforts, that IITs seem to be living in their own world. They don't care for us. That is nonsense, because for ages, IITs have been running QIP programs and several such things. Many of you and your colleagues would have benefited from that. But the scale at which this could be done was very limited, and the impression grew that IITs did not care. The participation in this national mission project is to give an unequivocal message to the entire country that not only we care, we will back up our assertion by actual action. I would submit that to a more or less similar extent, these 4,000 colleges would be saying the same thing about you, about your institutions. Do you care for colleges around you? You are better placed, you have better infrastructure, you have better and more experienced faculty, your students do better. Do you care for us? If I come from a small college in Jharsuguda or Khachro, do you care for me? The answer has to be yes. And what I would like you to carry back, see, it is not a mundane IST 2-week workshop that we are planning to conduct for 1,000 teachers. It is unlike any other workshop that you would have attended or you would have conducted. What we are trying to implant in our participating colleague teachers in the main workshop is the notion that quality education depends upon an empowered teacher as much as it does on the associated infrastructure, students, etc. That even if I am in a small college, even if my students are not as well prepared as students in your institutions or in IITs, I can deliver a far better quality of education to them in whatever subjects I teach, provided I feel confident that I can do that. Now, I put myself into the shoes of a teacher from a small college. I have three fundamental restrictions in the world. One is the restriction imposed by the university and the syllabus and the exam system. I am required to teach as per that syllabus. As I always maintain, a syllabus is at best a reflection of what part of past knowledge is considered useful. Syllabus actually is nothing going forward. Going forward, people will have to discover new things. Going forward, people will have to learn things which are not covered anywhere in the syllabus. That's the reason why in an autonomous institution such as IIT or NITs, when I teach a course, I decide what the syllabus is. I include the most recent things from either the journal papers or from latest textbooks. I set up new experiments. I encourage my students to think likewise. What I would like you to do is to put the same kind of enthusiasm in the hearts and minds of those 30, 35 teachers that will assemble at your place. Convince them that they can do much better than what they are. And additionally, convince them that they can do that in spite of the boundaries defined by their respective university. I don't know whether I have shared this with you or not. I had taken a one-year sabbatical in 2002-2003, and I went to 67 colleges in that year, talking, interacting with the students and teachers. I deliberately chose smaller colleges relative. And it was amazing to see great talent in each of those colleges. Not everybody was equally well prepared. Many could not speak correct English. I interacted with final year students doing their projects. But the amount of work that they had put in, the amount of thinking that they had put in. In every college, I could see 8, 10, 12 students whom I would love to have in my own college. You would have also come across such people in your own institutions and other places. Similarly, I found at every place one or two teachers who were doing something different. Now, that something different is becoming increasingly difficult to do. You will find that constraint yourself. But I'll mention one thing because it is an electronics course. In one college in Orissa, small place, I always ask the teachers that apart from the lab, what else do you do? What new things you do? So one teacher sheepishly told me that he conducts a lab on Sunday, electronics lab. 2 to 3 hours in the morning, every Sunday they spend, and the students and the teacher together decide on some complex circuit. Functionality is defined. They analyze the requirements, they design the circuit, they build the circuit, they test the circuit. Circuit is not just one circuit, there are multiple boards or whatever. And at the end of the semester, they make it working. I was very excited. I said, good, how many students come? Nahi sir, jyada log nahi aate hain. 15-20 log aate. The class strength is of 65. About 15 to 20 students come there. I said, my dear friend, those 15 to 20 students are going to make a lot of difference to this country and to themselves. Because they are the ones who are coming on a Sunday, doing something which is not stipulated in the syllabus. They are clearly not doing it for marks or exams, but they are interested. And then he told me a very interesting thing. He said, sir, you are the first one who is telling me I am doing something useful. All my colleagues laugh at me saying, syllabus chhod ke bahar ka padhata hai. Now, this mentality we want to kill. Many of you who are autonomous institutions will understand that syllabus is what you need to define to train the students for future. The problem is we have more than about 6 lakh students joining engineering every year, and 4,500 was as of last month. Today we don't know, there may be another 500 colleges added. Now, my appeal to you is, please join us in this national experiment and go beyond whatever you have discussed here. Because this is a basic course in electronics. As I was listening just for 5 minutes and as I had seen earlier in the meetings, even in basic electronics, there is no unanimity in the country as to what constitutes basic electronics. Different universities consider it differently. Okay. But fortunately, because it's a basic course, there is a lot of commonality. And our mandate is to empower teachers first in all the basic courses. In spite of it, don't get worried about the differences. I will go to the extent of saying that if you are courageous, in these 10 days, there is at least one Sunday in between. There are evenings and there are nights. Traditionally in IIT, maximum work happens in the nights. Except he goes away to, you know.
But these people have been working till late at night.
Now,
they have absorbed the ethos very quickly.
Now, that is what I want you to translate. Encourage them to participate in after dinner discussions. If some people want to sit late in the labs, encourage them to do that. Basically, make them think, make them raise issues. We have tried to make one difference from the conventional IST workshop. That we don't give certificates to those people at the end of 2 weeks. You have to form them into teams and they have to make some submission after working on that assignment for 2 more weeks. That's a mandatory requirement. And believe me, many teachers have reported to me based on our previous workshop experience that they find this teamwork after the workshop to be very fruitful. Several people came up with, sample questions and answers. Some people came up with project ideas. Some people came up with lab experiments, whatever it is. And as you all know, we are going to release all of this in open source. These contents would be available on a subject portal. And the first set of contributors to these subject portals will be the teachers who conduct that workshop, the teachers who coordinate the larger workshop, namely all of you, and the 1,000 participating teachers. Their names and photographs will be there in the portal saying they have initiated this portal. Imagine now if this enthusiasm spread, it spreads into say 500 colleges represented by these 1,000 teachers and then it spreads further. How much additional interaction, how much additional improvement in these contents, how much additional contributions could come over the next few years. My dream is that a good student in the smallest place should benefit positively from this effort, so that that student can do better than what he or she can do herself or himself. And an ordinary student should get confidence enough to at least clear the exams, which is apparently the main motivation for every student. So my request to you is that, and there would be problems, by the way. I don't deny that everything will be hunky-dory. We have made one change, which I don't know whether it has been shared with you or not. In the past two workshops, both the workshop themes were computer science themes. So consequently, the coordinating teachers who came like you were well-versed with the issues related to network technologies, issues related to audiovisual communication, etc., etc. So when they did coordination of those workshops, they handled everything. I will now be writing shortly a letter to all your institutions saying that in addition to the subject experts such as you, who would be concentrating on conducting this workshop and the labs for this subject, we would request each institution to nominate an additional faculty member, preferably one of those who have participated in the earlier workshop and they are familiar with the logistics handling, particularly of the audio-visual recording, transmission, reception, etc., etc., so that they will pay them some honorarium to respect whatever their contribution is. But for each future workshop, we would request a colleague of yours from your institution to take care of that part of the thing, so that you as subject experts have then an ability to concentrate only on the subject proper, the lectures and the labs. Of course, the lab for your course has to be your baby. Now, we had already taken a decision based on the great work done by my colleagues in the electrical engineering department to include an advanced topic. I believe you have discussed that card and other things with them. Yes, so you have those cards. We took a very bold decision, although I don't have a formal approval from the ministry for that. But then I never seek approvals. I seek apologies later if required. So I have decided that all participating teachers individually will be given the same card, so that when they go back to their institution, they carry some sweet memories, and those of them who are enthusiastic can perhaps do some advanced experiment. Basic electronics is not end of life, it is actually the beginning of life. And therefore, this is something that you should encourage the participating teachers to think that this is just the beginning and let them build further on. Someday, hopefully, there would be a commonality of the syllabi in the basic courses. We're trying to achieve it through a variety of mechanisms. Unfortunately, AICT and such bodies in the past had been doing everything else except education. Now my friend Mantha is trying to straighten that up, and hopefully over the coming years you will find the focus again on the education. But frankly, it is for you and us. At the end of the day, if something is wrong, we can't continuously blame other bodies such as AICT, or if something wrong in the city, we can't blame the municipal commissioner, something wrong in the state, we can't blame the chief ministers, although very respectfully most politicians should share that blame. Something wrong in the country, I can't say prime minister is responsible. Something wrong in the world, I can't say God is responsible. That's what we do. Ultimately, we have to say we are responsible. All that I am requesting you is take that responsibility. Each one of you take that responsibility. That no matter what happens in the rest of the country, you are a teacher. And teacher, okay, this is something which is a proposition of mine not accepted. In every living species that you see, only human species have something called a teacher. No other species have that. And that is because our knowledge grows so fast that humanity sometimes decided that you require a separate agency to cater to the consolidation, codification, and subsequently generation of new knowledge. And that is why humanity created an institution called a teacher. To support that institution, we created a lot of structures. They were called temples, mosques, etc. earlier. They were called ashrams in our earlier thing. Now they are called colleges and universities. Unfortunately, these support structures have become institutions, and we teachers have become paid employees of these institutions. And therefore, we no more regard ourselves as institutions imposed with the great responsibility of doing something for the next generation. Because we behave like paid employee. A paid employee does not take that responsibility in account. I would like you to think differently. And that stature is not given by humanity just like that. We have to work hard. I mean, if you recall the old ashrams which were known by the teachers, Sandipani ashram, Vashishta ashram or whatever, and that is because those teachers had earned that stature. I think we need to tell ourselves and our other colleagues to get into that stature. It is doable, it is eminently doable, because in this country there is still some respect left for teachers, at least in the minds of students, and this happens in spite of coaching classes. So given that, I would like you to go beyond the boundaries of the subject. You will primarily be dealing with that subject. Your primary ambition is to empower the participating teachers to become absolutely top class in that subject, namely basic electronics. But please go beyond that and put some, what I don't have any word but to say, put some ethos and put some confidence that our students and we ourselves can be the best engineers and the best engineering teachers in the world. It doesn't matter whether we come from small place or big place. As you would have seen, my colleagues, Professor Sharma, Professor Patel, Professor Jan, and I think Prakash Apte was also involved some extent. Yes. These, myself, we are all people like you. A very comparable common thing that we all did, all of us without exception, which is intellectually a great achievement. We learnt a foreign language between the age of 2 years and 6 years. Subsequently, that language was called our mother tongue. You did it, I did it, he did it, everybody did it. I am not suggesting that all human beings are intellectually equal. But what I am suggesting is that every human being has been endowed by God with absolutely adequate intellectual capacity to solve complex logical problems. It is just the shortage of confidence which unfortunately we teachers create by successively evaluating a student only on the basis of marks that are scored. So you got 90% marks, you are a genius. I got 40% marks, I am an idiot. I am actually not. But the way my teachers behave with me, the way my colleague students behave with me, the way the society behaves with me, and finally the way my father tells me, "Tera kya hoga lalu?" I actually lose all my confidence and start really behaving so badly that I actually become a duffer. All that we need to do is rekindle that confidence. Look, if you could learn your mother tongue, then you can learn anything else. And this is eminently learning. I'm sorry, I can go on and on, but I would like to stop here because we need about 5-10 minutes to distribute these certificates. And I would also like my colleague, Professor Dinesh Sharma, to say a few words in conclusion. But I must end by saying that when we started this, I was not sure how much we will succeed in conducting workshops in other core subjects. The first time we deviated from computer science, something that we knew, but we deviated where mechanical and electrical engineering, my colleague Professor Uday Gayatonde and Professor Karmakar just recently conducted a course on thermodynamics, and four of my colleagues have come forward to conduct this course on basic electronics. If you believe that this is useful, and based on the feedback that we receive from the 1,000 teachers, we would be encouraged to demand from the Government of India some additional support to conduct some advanced courses. And as it is, even in this course, we are including something useful. So please spread the word. The main workshops for these two subjects, thermodynamics and the basic electronics, would be conducted this June. We are conducting a very special program on a course which is not a core subject today, and that relates to photovoltaic cells. Now, photovoltaic cells, maybe 15 years hence, will be a core course. Today it is not. It's considered advanced research. So several of my colleagues, spanning departmental boundaries, the effort is being led by people like Professor Zuzer Vasi, Ram Gopal Rao, then Chetan Solanki of mechanical engineering, and so on. So you see, knowledge really has no boundaries. We have created these artificial boundaries, and we now want to tell our students that in order to solve problems in real life, please think beyond bounds. So that's all I have to say. Thank you very much. And please go back in the comfort that the preparation based on all the interaction that you had, and I was watching as Professor Patil was explaining, it appears to me that by and large there is an agreement on the topics that you want to discuss there. And I hope that this will benefit those teachers. But do take good care of them. I hope you were taken care of well here. I hope you had comfortable stay. Unfortunately, I don't think we could arrange accommodation for all of you in this place. So where did you do that?
Samir
guest house. Did you make them walk from Samir every day? Or tum-tum ticket. Wow.
There's
There's no breakfast in Samir. Anyway, we have our limitations, as I am sure all of you would have some limitations in your institutions. But I would also like to take this opportunity to thank my team. You would have seen them interacting with you. They have always been there. And another suggestion is try to create and enhance such teams at your place who will take care of your guests when they come. I hope your stay was comfortable and you took something more than just the electronics discussion from here. The visit the electrical engineering department, they must have gone there for the labs and so on.
Okay.
Oh, that all of us habitually do. I mean, you would be doing that with people who learn from you. And in that respect, there is, there is nothing like a student and teacher. If I am learning, I am a student. That's the first thing. When I like most of you, I also come from a college in Indore, JSITS. I see somebody from JSITS here. And I was quite pleasantly surprised when, as a young teacher, I found two very senior professors of my department sitting in my course on programming, because a new mainframe machine had just arrived. Before that, we used to all write programs on a Minsk II Russian computer in a language called autocoder for engineers. And then suddenly Fortran and PL1 fell upon us. So we started conducting some lectures on Saturdays, Sundays and evenings. And people like Professor Revankar and Professor K.C. Mukherjee would personally sit in our class. We used to be embarrassed, but they said, no, treat us as students. We want to learn. This is the first lesson we learned, that learning can be from any human being, irrespective of age, caste, creed, language, religion, stature. And I would like you to carry back that message also to our colleague teachers. So that's all I have to say.
So they have been hearing more than a few words from me. So we have had a few discussions, but I'm sorry I came in a little late. I don't know whether you have had time to discuss some of the practical. We had impromptu session.
Discuss sessions and practicals.
Yeah. So here, okay. So those have been tackled. Sure. And a Moodle-like interface has been set up for setting up. For giving you course material, and Moodle is actually it's a bit difficult to use the first time around. By the way, I found it a little difficult to get used to the first time around. But it is a very powerful medium, and let it be a source of contact. And our contact is not restricted to basic electronics. If you have interest, by all means, let us know that, you know, that I find this interesting or that interesting. Who can guide me? And we'll forward your message to the appropriate people so that you can be in touch with those people. I would like to register our thanks to Professor Phatak and his team. This is the way we work here in this institute. One fine day, Professor Phatak just called me and he said that I want you to teach 1,000 college teachers. And the part which was the most encouraging was that his tone told me answer in yes or yes sir. So there was no room to say no, but there was no expectation that we would say no. And indeed, it's a great privilege to work with his team. It has been honestly a great pleasure to have interacted with you. When you try something And the other side reacts as if, oh, what a great burden it is, and because we have to come here and we've been nominated to attend a course and therefore we are coming here. Then there is one level of response that you generate. And when there is, you know, that ignition that you feel, and that, you know, we go one step and you go a step and a half ahead of us, then it creates a great deal of enthusiasm. And if you ask me, that is the real payment of teaching. Whether it is your students or your colleagues that you are discussing with you and so on, when you start something and then everybody gets enthusiastic about it and the whole thing moves forward and you feel that resonance among yourself, that is the real pleasure of the life of a teacher. And thanks for having exposed us to that pleasure again. And I hope you do the same in your centers when the people come. It is very important for people to feel this sense of the occasion and almost the mission feeling that courses like this have generated. And we hope that there will be many more such courses in which we will be able to participate. It is a great feeling that we are making impact not only in quality, but in a large enough quantity to have an overall impact. And I hope that this effort has a multiplier effect and we will be able to reach out even more people in the future. Thanks.
Thank you, Prof. Sharma. We'll now do the honors of distributing the certificates. There's something which we don't do for the 1,000 teachers, as I told you. There we'll be printing these certificates, writing the individual names, and there'll be names of one of you as coordinators for the respective institute and the course coordinator here. And you will be sending this certificate by post to the participating teacher after he or she has submitted the group assignment to a satisfaction. I hope that is okay. Each one of us requires some external audit to prod us to action. So it is useful to have it. Right. Shrimati Vasant Lakshmi from SIT Amlapuram. Oh, wow. Andhra Pradesh is participating well now. Thank you so much. Mukesh Patil from Baramati. Good. So I hope you are able to get sufficient number of teachers to Sandeep Nalage from Phenolex Academy, Ratnagiri. Last time also there was someone from Phenolex. Thank you. Lavin Haswani from R.C. Patel Institute, Jaipur. R.C. Patel has been a partner in this endeavor for quite some time, right from the beginning in fact. Although Jaipur is a small place, I was worried whether there will be enough teachers to assemble at that remote center. But I think they gather everybody from Jalga, Dhulia, and everywhere. And of course, these days there are engineering colleges everywhere in the country. Yes, we speak of the Tuba College. Tuba College of Engineering. Mr. Rajin Gupta, thank you for coming. I have to visit this college once next time when I come to Indore. Ye Varghese Titus from Amar Jyoti College of Engineering, Kottayam. Thank you for coming. P. Veramurli from Periyar Muniyamma University, Tanjavur. I went to Tanjavur in December, but it was a holiday when I was there, so I could not visit your next season. I will come next time. Thank you. E. Shivakumar from SRM University, Chennai. Thank you very much for coming. Ajay Thakere from Yashwantrao Chavan College of Engineering, Nagpur. Thank you for coming. Sunil Kore from Wharton College, Sanghvi. Are you any relation to the great Tata Sahib Kore? You are? Wow. There is something that you should tell people proudly of. Let's say heritage of that area is not matched by many people. Thanks for coming. K. Murugan from Anna University, Chennai. Anna University has been another strong partner in our endeavor for all the 2 years. Thank you. Nazia Hussain from IPS Academy, Indore. Thanks for coming. Matik K. Yola Sugan, Pantai Periyar Government Institute of Technology, Vellore, or another institute at Vellore. Thanks for coming. Abhilash Manroy from SNIT Surat. Surat is another NIT which has been participating with us in all our endeavors. Thank you so much. Milind Marathe from Tejas Somaya. Yeah, Somaya is also on the issue which has been there. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Krishna.
Vishal Sarpote from NIT Nagpur. Nagpur now has a large number of colleges. So I hope you take good care of them to start. Thank you. R.K. Sharma from Kurukshetra. In the last workshop, nobody from Kurukshetra could come. I am very happy that you have. Kurukshetra is there, I see. Hamirpur Sangha. Thank you so much for that. Niku Bedi from St. Joseph College of Engineering Technology, Palai. Where is Palai?
Kerala.
No, which place in Kerala?
Kottayam.
Thank you very much. Dr. Bhavna Jharia from Jabalpur Engineering College. Jabalpur Engineering College has been a recent addition to our endeavor. And as I told the previous participant, I should be coming there someday.
Okay,
sir. Although I will be on a holiday. I have to show my wife Bhedaja. I have
okay,
seen
sir.
It five times.
Yes, sir. No, sir.
Pastor Pratim Roy, Don Bosco College of Engineering and Technology, Guwahati. Finally, we have from Don Bosco. And Guwahati is the eastern-most corner. Thank you so much for coming. So, how many colleges do you have there?
Around
6-7 colleges. Round up all teachers who claim to know electronics and teach them electronics. I Tate from MEPCO Shred. One of the best institutions I have seen in the South. Thanks for coming. The Gauri Shankar Reddy from SCU College of Indian Tirupati. SCU College of Indian, I had a couple of invitations from this college. Thank you so much. Manisha Satone from KK Bad Institute. KK Bad Nasik is another institution in Maharashtra which has some pioneering activities, particularly in terms of deputing their teachers for MTech and PhD programs. Thank you for coming. S. Sundar from Vellore Institute of Technology, Vellore. Of course, Vellore Institute has been our partners right from the beginning. Thank you for listening.
Thank you.
Prashant Parekh from Jaipur Indian College, Kokas. Jaipur Indian College is another of our old partners. Someday I will come to Kokas and meet you today. Harare from MES Pillai Institute of Information Technology, New Panvera. So you have the responsibility of taking care of all the teachers in that area of Mumbai. Yeah. All the best. S. Raghavendra from SJ College of Engineering, Mysore. So Mysore is added to our map now. Thank you very much, Professor, for coming. Ms. Anjulata Yadav, my college. Thanks for coming. P. Nagarajan from Vivekananda Engineering College for Women. Spiritual Guru. Where is Spiritual Guru?
Namakka.
Yes, S. Prasad, Kakinada Institute of Engineering and Technology, Kakinada. Thanks for coming. I hope you enjoyed the course. Mohammed Iftikhar Ahmed of Mukhamja College of Engineering and Technology, Hyderabad. Andhra Pradesh has, I think, one of the largest number of engineering colleges in the country.
Around 600 colleges.
Around 600. Yes. We will take care of 100 of them because there are only 6 people from Andhra Pradesh.
Yeah, no. Hyderabad has got around 150 colleges around it.
All the best.
So there is sparing this in the.
Thank you. Thank you. All the best. Thank you for that. Mrs. Smriti Pore from BKT Textile Engineering Institute. It is one of the best institutions in textile engineering in the country. And very dedicated set of people. Thanks for coming. I visited your college once 2 years ago. SKLV Sai Prakash from NIT Warangal. Warangal, Trichy, these are the people whom we consider to be our close associates. Thank you so much. Please give my regard to your director. I did not recognize him when I saw him. He was my colleague researcher here in IIT many years. Ramarao, right?
Yes.
Amit Kumar Khade from Cummings College, Pune. One of the few engineering colleges for women and a very well recognized institution. But don't limit this workshop only to lady teachers. Please also accommodate male teachers.
Yes,
thank you. CV Nagendran Amrita Koyanpur. the AVU software which you will be using for remote sakshatkar comes from the Amrita Institute. Thank you very much. Nitin Kothari from Techno India, India Institute of Technology, Udaipur. Wow. The place of Lake Palace.
Yes, thanks and public.
Yes. Thank you so much. So you have several engineering colleges in Udaipur and nearby?
There are 11 engineering colleges.
11? The whole of Udaipur is only engineering colleges now or what? There hardly anything to write for that. Good, good. So do a good job there.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
C.V. Giriraja from Amrita School of Engineering, Bangalore. So Bangalore also has a Amrita presence. Thank you so much. Umer Khan from DOSCC Center, Srinagar. I must tell you something very special about this center. The first course, the workshop which we conducted on computer programming, there was turmoil in Kashmir. And people would hesitate to take out their vehicles, scooters or cars to move around. There were teachers attending this course at DOESCC center in Srinagar who walked 10 kilometers to attend that day. So very, very enthusiastic crowd. Thank you so much. Thank you for coming and all the best. Okay, so that's it. Thank you so much and all the best for this endeavor. God bless you.